In this lecture, we are going to see the parser lexer communication. In the previous lectures, we have seen separately what lexer is and what parser is. And according to that, we have seen the example of lexer also. So, in this lecture, let us see how the parser and lexer communicates with each other. I, Professor D.V. Kosti, welcome you. So the theory behind this particular bit is, when you see a lex scanner and a YAC parser together, the parser is the highest level routine. Parser calls the lexer, YYLEX, whenever it needs a token from the input. So in the front end of the toy compiler, we have seen lexical analysis, syntax analysis, and semantic analysis. In the lexical analysis, lexemes are found, that means tokens are created. And whatever the output is there from the lexical analysis is given to the syntax analysis. So lexical analysis is nothing but we say scanner, and syntax analysis is nothing but parser. So parsing and scanning goes hand in hand. So whenever there is an input required for the parser, it calls the lexer YYLEX, and YYLEX forms the token and gives input for the parser. Now, when the lexer scans through the input, recognizing tokens, and when it does this task, it returns the token immediately to the parser. So, as a returning value, it returns code as the value of YYLEX. So what that code is, that we are going to see in the coming slides. Now, as we know, not all the tokens are processed by the parser, like white spaces, comma, semicolon. So these are the parts of syntax, but are not processed. So here the example is given, comments and white spaces. So comments are omitted, and white spaces are also omitted by the scanner to form token. So whatever the omitted part is there, comments and white spaces are not at all processed and not given as an input to the parsing phase. So we call these are the ignored tokens, and the lexer is not going to return anything for such a input. And it will just go to the next token to create, and it will give the next token to the parser. That's why heading is, not all tokens are of interest to the parser. Next is, what is token codes? So lexer and parser have to agree what the token codes are. So every time it is very much impossible to return directly token. So the code is decided for every token. So we solve this problem by letting YAC define the token codes. The tokens in our grammar are noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, preposition, and conjunction. So you can suppose these are some types of tokens. In the system programming, we have seen the types of tokens are symbols, identifiers, constants. So symbols and identifiers are same, but identifiers and constant we have seen. Similarly, we have reserved words. These are of some different type of token. So here example is taken as a English language. In that, tokens may be of type noun, pronoun, verb, adjective, preposition, and conjunction. Now, YAC defines each of these as a small integer using a preprocessor hash define. So whatever is defined by YAC is called as token codes. Now, the example of token codes is on the next slide. You can see here. If a token is found and it matches with noun, YAC returns the value 257. Similarly, 258, 259, 260, 261, 262, and 263. Depending on the type of input, a particular number will be returned, and this number is nothing but code for a particular token. I hope you understood this. See the heading of previous slide, token codes. So these are the token codes for the different type of tokens shown on the screen. I hope you understood this. This is how the parser and lexer communicates with each other. Now the last part is, what is returned for the end of the input? The answer for this is 0 is returned for the end of the string or end of the input. So YAG does not define a symbol for it, but you can yourself define if you want. So there is no need to define any symbol for end of string. YAG optionally writes a C header file containing all the token definitions. So as we know, hash define is a preprocessor. So at the header place, the YAG defines everything. You include this file called y.tab.h on Unix system and ytab.h or yytab.h on Microsoft DOS in the lexer and use the preprocessor symbols in your lexer action code. So this is what the name of the file is given depending on the operating system. So I hope you understood this lecture. Concluding remark, as we have seen how lexer and parser communicates with each other. The slide credit goes to Lex and YAG, written by Limine, Mason, and Bro. Happy learning. Do subscribe the channel to get the notification of new videos. Thank you very much. We'll meet in the next lecture.